are simply demons and dark angels. So they do have that category. They do have that belief. And within Christianity, you'll find many different beliefs about who the specific angels are and what
presence are they just like, right? They do have a physical presence. And they have a pretty dominating physical presence, right? And, you know, a lot of times when you see portrayals of angels, because, again, you'll find them even in the thought of Confucius, there's a belief most merciful. So if you looked up a Wikipedia entry of Gabriel, for example, and you saw the portrayal, right, and you see the portrayal of most angels in drawings and in sculpture, you'll find that they look like babies in diapers, right? They're very weak, small creatures, kind of animals that do as they are commanded, that exclude all forms of fault, all forms of flaw, all forms of impurity. Just as we testify that the messengers of God, all of them, Abraham, Noah, Jesus, Moses, David, peace be upon them all, just as we testify that they are all infallible, and that they do not commit those mistakes, the angels as well are completely infallible and do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with anything that's been given to them. As Allah tells us in the Quran, لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرْهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ The angels of punishment. And Jibreel alayhi salam as well, having a character. Now what do they look like? Alright? Allah tells us they do have wings, not those two little weak feathery wings that you see. They do have wings. What do you actually have? That are praying there with you. You think you're in your room all by yourself. You've got angels, creatures the size of mountains, that are there praying with you, that are there glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you. Alright? What about an angel that has a bigger task than them? An angel that belongs to a more elite group of angels. How about Hamalat al-Arsh, the bearers of the throne? Right? We mentioned them in our supplications. Allahumma inni asbahtu ushidu wa ushidu hamalat al-arshi. You know, we call them to bear witness at times. So the distance between his earlobe and his shoulder is a journey of 700 years. A bird could fly that journey in 700 years. So it's not just you walking and taking breaks. If a bird was flying continuously for 700 years, he'd only make it from here to here on one of those angels. So how do we even determine who's a bigger angel and who's a smaller angel? And what does this have to do with Jibreel alayhi salam? The greater the task the angel has been given, the greater the size of the angel. In certain ways, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do so. So there's a very famous hadith in Sahih Muslim where a man is walking and he hears a voice coming from the clouds and it says this thing, hadith is the one known in the heart, the garden of so-and-so.
Today, less energy than the other one.
I'll just get one today.
And that is
होता है उसे
हम पर रखता है।